Hey guys, welcome back to the DWF. It's your host, Dan WrestleFan here. And by the time this video comes up, you've probably already seen part one. We've done our March Madness bracket. That's right, we have been doing a March Madness bracket style of theme songs that Drake Valentine would like to, if these theme songs did not exist yet in WWE, what would Drake Valentine want to come out to? Our first video was narrowing down from 32 competitors' theme songs down to 16. Now, we are at the Sweet 16 point, boys. That's where we are. I think I've played all the theme songs or most of the theme songs in the first video, so I'm not going to play them again. If you guys are watching this, you've probably already seen the first video. If you haven't seen the first video, go check it out. Now's your time. You know what? I'm going to give you a minute. Okay. Is that enough time? There's a few seconds. Enough time for you to click off this video so you can go see the first one. So at least you'll know what the theme songs sound like. You'll know what's going up against what version of each theme song we used. And now we get into the more fun side of it, I guess. We're going to go with our bracket. We have our winner from the first round, number one, Batista, going against number 31, DX. That actually stood them next to each other. I didn't even realize. So we had Batista's theme song, I Walk Alone, versus D-Generation X. Both of these songs are good. If you guys forgot, Drake Valentine is more of a charismatic, high-flying, always moving, like a guy who likes to move around a lot. He's got a lot of energy, as I always seem to have energy. My wife tells me all the time. I have got way too much energy. Since having the little one, though, I don't know. I mean, my daughter, I think, has more energy than I do these days. But regardless, I'm still very hyperactive and always moving, always into something. So I need something that's got that kind of energy that I can run out there, jump around, engage with the crowd. So we're with Batista, I Walk Alone, and D-Generation X. I gotta tell you guys, I think I've gotta go with Batista on this. I love I Walk Alone. That song is so good. It is so solid. It is so hard to beat. While I also... I do love D-Generation X, though. The more I'm thinking about it, I might have answered too soon. I'm changing my answer. We're gonna change it. Batista, I'm sorry. I don't think your song is going to carry Drake Valentine. I don't think it's got enough in that song that makes me want to keep going. But D-Generation X, the song is so good and it keeps going and you get so much of it. It just keeps carrying that energy. The more I'm thinking about it, I like this decision. We're gonna go with D-Generation X for the win. They move on to the Elite Eight. Let's see who's going to join D-Generation X song there. All right, guys, next up, we had entrant number three, Hulk Hogan, who moved on with entrant number four, Seth Rollins, using the Burn It Down song, not his visionary song, but his original The Second Coming or Burn It Down, the one that had the drums, then they yell Burn It Down, and then it goes into the guitar riff. And as much as I like Hulk Hogan's song, it's just a fun, upbeat, Real American is just a fun song. It is very dated, and it's not going to see the light of the next round. It's not making it to the Elite Eight. Sorry, Hogan. I love your song. It's just not the song that I want to come out to. I think The Second Coming or Burn It Down is the better song. I really love like the drum leading up to the yelling Burn It Down, where you can do some fire pyrotechnics, and then right into a guitar riff. Like, it is such a good, such a solid, fun, awesome song. It's got to be Rollins, baby. Next, we have number 28, the Usos theme song. I think I've been putting the first guy on this side. The Usos theme song at number 28, taking on number 6, Edge Metalingus. I didn't even remember what the Usos song sounded like, and because they split up now and did their own songs. Basically, it's the exact same thing, except they were both on it. Sorry, Usos. Metalingus is one of the greatest songs in WWE or just wrestling history. It is one of the top tier songs ever. Edge is moving right along. Sorry, Usos. That was like an absolute blowout between the last two. The next are kind of the same. We've got Eddie Guerrero at number 26. And then we've got number 8, CM Punk, Cult of Personality. It's, again, I Lie, I Cheat, I Steal is a good song. But for what Drake Valentine wants to come out to, it does not hold a torch. Not even a sniff to Cult of Personality. Sorry, Eddie. Gotta send you home here. Punk, you're moving on. All right, guys, you know the next ones. We've got The Miz, who is at number 24, taking on number 10, Cody Rhodes. AJ, I'm going to set you back here because I don't want people to be confused because you just keep standing in next to everybody. We've got The Miz taking on Cody Rhodes. I love The Miz's theme song, but Cody's is really good too. However, what would Drake Valentine prefer to come out to? This is going to be an upset, and it's going to be a shocker. And if you guys are mad, I am so sorry. But it's got to be The Miz. It's got so much more energy to it. Cody's song is perfect for Cody Rhodes. But it is not what Drake Valentine wants. I'm sorry, Cody. You got to go down with your ship here. Miz, you're moving on to the Elite Eight. All right, next. Sorry, guys. I know that one was a bit of a shocker. Even as I was setting the figures up, I wasn't entirely sure who I was going to pick on that. But, hey, it's got to happen. What you got to do, you got to do. Next is number 11, AJ Styles, taking on number 21, Christian, who they both have really good songs. Oh, my gosh. Give me a second here, guys. Yeah, I had to go back and listen to those songs real quick. It's got to be. Christian has such a banger song, guys. His song slaps so hard, and like no one remembers it because he's maybe forgotten. Do people still remember his go? Like, do people still remember that? Or do I just not remember it? Because like I was talking to all my friends and stuff before I even came up with the idea of this video, and no one remembers Christian's song, and it's like, is he forgotten about in WWE? I hope not. He had a great career in WWE, and he has one of the best songs ever, which is why he's moving on. All right, and if you guys remember from the last video, we used a different figure because we don't want to idolize a bad person. But we have the Crippler here at number 14, taking on RVD, who is number 13. This one is... It's kind of tough for its own reasons, but I think it's got to be the Crippler. I like RVD's One of a Kind, but it's not my favorite song. It takes a little bit to get going. The Crippler is just kind of, it's there, it's ready to go. So I think the Crippler is going to move on here. And finally, guys, to round out our 32, we have, I think it's 18, Chris Jericho, and 16, Jeff Hardy. This might be one of the most one-sided matches I think we've had here on the Sweet 16, and it's Jeff Hardy. I mean, no chance. I like Break the Walls Down, but it is not an elite song for Drake Valentine. Drake Valentine wants something he can run out there to, dance around, get, you know, jump around, get the fans really involved, and I think No More Words is the song to do that. All right, guys, it's time to go from Elite Eight to Final Four. We have number 31, D-Generation X, taking on number 4, Seth Rollins, Burn It Down version, not the Visionary version. And while this one required a lot of thought, the only right answer for Drake Valentine is Seth freaking Rollins. Moving right along. You know, Seth Rollins was going up against, I think his toughest competition was the very first one he had to go against Sami Zayn, Worlds Apart. I really think both of them could be here in this Elite Eight. And I think both of them probably could make it to Final Four. I don't know. They both had, that was the toughest competition I think I had from the original 32, but here we are. I may have spoke too soon because I now have probably the toughest decision of all decisions. I have number 6, Edge Metalengus, and I have number 8, CM Punk Cult of Personality. Two of my absolute favorite songs. I'm telling you right now, if the guys made it this far, they're probably in like my WWE royalty of theme songs. This is got to be one of the toughest. I'm actually already listened to these like 3 times each before recording, and I've got to go listen to them again, guys. I'll be right back. All right, guys. So it's the next morning. I may have spent way too much time trying to listen to these songs and then got hungry, went to grab a snack, and forgot what I was doing and forgot to come back. But I'm here now. Welcome back to the DW. Oh, wait, no, that's right. You're still watching the same video. Anyway, here we are. We've got CM Punk Cult of Personality and Edge Metalengus. This has to be the hardest decision of theme songs of what I would want my character to come out to, because I love both of these songs so much, and I could really see like using either one of these songs. This is really, really tough. I wish these two were battling in the Final Four instead of the Elite Eight, but after most of the night thinking and stewing on this, I've got to go with Edge and Metalengus. This song, his song is just full start to finish, almost every single thing I want in a theme song. And CM Punk's is very, very close. I just love the way that Edge's starts. It's just so like, it just gets you going. The drums and stuff really get you going, build up that energy, and just get you so excited. It's such a good, and like just beginning to an entrance. Just amazing. It was a really tough decision, but we've got to go with Edge. Next, guys, we have number 24, The Miz, going up against number 21, Christian. And this is another, every single one of these I had to put a good bit of thought into and listen to the songs a time or two before making a decision. And again, I still feel myself leaning towards Christian. I think this song is very underrated. He has one of the possibly most underrated theme songs of WWE. This is a very tough video to do, but I think I've got to go with Christian on this one. And finally, for the Elite Eight, we have the Crippler at number 14, taking on number 16, Jeff Hardy. And you guys know I love No More Words. So it's, this one is probably the one I had to do that had the least amount of thought in, perhaps. It's got to be No More Words. That song is just so, so good. Thank you, Jeff, for bringing one of the greatest theme songs ever to WWE. Here we are, guys. It is time to go from Final Four and bring it to 2. We've got number 4, Seth Rollins, versus number 6, Edge. What theme song would I rather come out to? Both of them are incredible. Incredible, incredible songs. Both of them are very rock and roll. Both of them are a lot of the things I really, really, really look for in a theme song. However, one of them stands out above the other. And it's got to be Metalengus standing out over top of Seth Rollins. Sorry, Seth. Your song was amazing. Visionary's good. It's just not the one that I'm as into. And then we've got No More Words battling off against... go when you can... I forget what Christian's... Close Your Eyes? Is that what it's called? When you close your... Yeah, I think it is. When You Close Your Eyes. So, No More Words battling off against Close Your Eyes. Again, two amazing, amazing theme songs. What will Drake Valentine prefer to come out to? It's gotta be No More Words. I love some good old No More Words from Jeff Hardy, one of the greatest theme songs ever. And now we are at our finale. What is the best WWE theme song? Leave it in the comments below. Let me know what your favorite is. Let me know what your character would come out to. Is it either one of these? Is it any of the ones we've had in the video? Is your character more of a brawling type person who wants to come out to a slower, more intimidating? Because, trust me, if my character was more of a brawler, heavy hitter, even tactician, I don't think these would be my same theme songs. This is my character, Drake Valentine, being the high-flying, charismatic, fun, energy absorbing, always moving person. And there's really only one choice of theme song he can come out to, only one theme song here that fits and captures everything that I'm looking for with the pyrotechnics, the really good intro leading to a great, a high energy, high movement. There can only be one. It's time to Highlander this. And your winner is none other than Edge with Metalingus. I know this is probably the most basic way to say that Edge's song is my favorite song, and hopefully the Rocket was fun at least. But guys, that's it. We've finally reached the end of this. I think this is only a two-parter, right? So we did the first part where we played the songs for everybody, and then the second part here, we got down to our number one. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this. Leave it in the comments below. Let me know what you thought. If you want to see more stuff like this, I am also going to be possibly attempting this with a few friends, trying to do just the best theme song instead of songs that we want to come out to. We're going to just try and, because there are a lot of iconic songs I didn't put in, right? I didn't have The Rock, I didn't have Stone Cold, I didn't have Undertaker. A lot of those songs that I just knew right off the bat are not songs that my character would want to come out to at all. So this one I was trying to make more personal. Next one we might make it open and do something more fun and just do the best theme song in all of WWE. And if Edge wins that one, guys, then obviously this is all one big conspiracy.